Happening right now, saying goodbye. The emotional tribute taking place as local law enforcement pay their respects to an officer taken too soon. Plus, Governor Pritzker is coming to the state line. The bill he's signing that some hope could help boost production at a local factory. Plus, 13 News just obtained these photos from police. What officers say the people in these pictures are accused of doing and how you can help get them caught and cuffed.
From 13 WREX, your weather authority, this is 13 News at 6.
Happening right now, first responders from across the state line forming a procession for a Beloit police officer who passed away due to COVID-19 complications. 13 News' William Ingalls joins us live from the procession route. William, tell us more about this emotional tribute and the officer.
Yeah, Brittany, right behind me here at the UW Health Renaissance Pavilion, there are officers from across our area, Rockford, Loves Park, Roscoe, Rockton, and Officer Daniel Daly spent a lot of time here in the state line, both with the Rockton Police Department, a number of security companies, including the BMO Harris Bank Center, of course, at the time called the Metro Center when he worked there. And his coworkers remember him as a dependable teammate who could always have his friends and coworkers back, even if that meant going into dangerous situations. One of his coworkers said he needed to replace his glasses a number of times after getting broken during arrest. But both on and off the job, Daly was known as a loyal, reliable coworker, and more importantly, a friend.
He was a well-liked man. He was a go-getter, very loyal. I enjoyed working with him. I could always count on him if I needed him.
And behind me, this procession is going to start here any minute. It was scheduled for 6, probably just getting a few last things in line before it starts. But we'll have live coverage of that procession here on air and on our Facebook page, WREX.com, as well. So we're going to go for now, but we'll be back when this procession starts. But for now, reporting live in Rockford, I'm going to send it back to you, Brittany, in the studio.
Well, thank you for that. We'll check back in with you in a few moments. Well, the flurries are gone, but that wintry weather isn't over just yet. Alex tracks how long the chilly air sticks around for us, Alex.
So we'll have about another 12 hours or so of this chill, and then things warm up dramatically tomorrow. We are looking dry, though, even with the big change in temperature ahead. Any flurries from earlier today, they are well off to our southeast, and they'll stay there as of tonight. So look for just some cloud cover overhead. That'll help keep a little warmth around overnight, though we don't have much to begin with. Right around freezing now, we'll drop a few degrees, possibly as much as about 5 degrees, and that is about it as we go into the overnight hours. So we'll be down into the 20s, but really not deep into the 20s. And then after a chilly start to the week, we are back into the 50s tomorrow. Though, like we usually see in November, that warmth doesn't last long. Coming up the forecast, I'll track just how long it sticks around. For now, Brittany, back to you.
Alex, thanks for that. And as we prepare for winter, local leaders want people in our underserved communities to know that help is available. 13 News' Cassandra Brunel joins us in studio. Cassandra, walk us through what people who need assistance need to know about this.
Yeah, Brittany, the Rockford Rescue Mission is just one of the many places helping thousands of our neighbors find warm meals and safe housing. But it takes more than providing food and shelter to solve homelessness, and organizations need your help to do it.
It takes a village to care for the most vulnerable population.
The work involved in getting a person or a family out of poverty into safe housing and employment can't be done by one person and cannot be done by one agency.
I mean, we want to end a family or an individual's incidence of homelessness as quickly as possible, and knowing what other resources in the community exist, that's really important for us.
That's why agencies banded together to create the Northern Illinois Homeless Coalition. The coalition has offered more than 48,000 nights of emergency shelter and offered hundreds of people transitional, rapid, and permanent housing.
Do you know that the city would put you on a list and you could probably get an apartment? Do you know that Carpenter's Place has 14 areas of life they will work with you on?
Meeting people where they are, as well as addressing what led to homelessness so it doesn't happen again.
Some lose jobs. Some have suffered from domestic violence, and so they've had to leave a bad situation, so they're homeless. We have a lot of mental illness that they just need the proper counseling or medications.
The Freeport Area Church Cooperative is not only in the Northwestern Continuum of Care, but also partners with the Freeport Police Department, Workforce Connection, FHN Counseling, and more, so it can meet the complex needs of chronic homelessness in Stevenson County. But this week, these organizations are counting on you.
We always need money. Everyone always needs money because that's what helps bridge the gap between government and foundation grants and the services we provide. There isn't an entity that's funding anyone 100%.
Funding not just to end homelessness, but to extend a hand to a neighbor.
And the Freeport Area Church Cooperative, they will be downtown Freeport all week long collecting donations so that they can add more beds and extend its services. And in Rockford, Mayor Tom McNamara, you heard him just there, he's encouraging the community to donate time and resources to these organizations, working one-on-one with people to get them on their feet and beyond. Brittany, back to you.
Cassandra, thank you for that. New tonight, 13 News has learned that Governor J.B. Pritzker will be in the state line tomorrow morning. The governor will be in Belvedere, where he will sign a bill that incentivizes electric vehicle manufacturing. Rockford Representative Dave Vella filed the bill in September and then passed through the Illinois House during the fall veto session last month. We'll carry the governor's news conference live tomorrow morning on our 13 News app as well as on WREX.com. At this hour tonight, the jury in the Kyle Rittenhouse trial is one step closer to deliberations. This is one count against Rittenhouse. Possession of a dangerous weapon was dismissed. The judge gave the jury a lengthy set of instructions concerning the remaining charges they must consider. Following closing arguments, the pool of 18 will be randomly reduced to 12, who will then deliberate and render a verdict. New developments tonight in the trial of three men accused of killing Ahmaud Arbery. Civil rights leader Reverend Jesse Jackson attended the court proceedings today to support the Arbery family. The defense asked the judge to remove Reverend Jackson from the courtroom, saying his presence might influence the jurors. The judge denied the request, as well as the defense's motion for a mistrial due to Mr. Jackson's presence. Happening right now, police are asking for your help finding three suspects who allegedly robbed a Rockford Walgreens. Take a look at these security cam photos. Police say it happened just before 5 o'clock Sunday morning at the store in the 2300 block of Charles Street. Three armed men entered the store and demanded cash before leaving. Anyone with information is being asked to contact Rockford police. Happening right now, we want to take you another live look at first responders from across the state line. They are forming a procession for a Beloit police officer. You can see those sirens and those cars going past. This is all for an officer who passed away due to complications from COVID-19. 13 News' William Ingalls joins us there live right now from that procession route. William, what can you tell us about this?
Right, Brittany, a somber scene here outside of UW Health in downtown Rockford. The last of the cars actually just passed me. You can probably still see them on our camera that we have just a little bit further down 9th Street, all to honor Officer Daniel Daly, who passed away from COVID-19 earlier today. And his coworkers remember him as a dependable teammate. He always had his friends and coworkers' backs, even if that meant him going into dangerous situations. And one of his coworkers remembers how he had to get his glasses replaced a number of times because of all the arrests that he had and some of them getting a little bit rough at times. Of course, though, they remember him during his time off of the force, whether it was with Rockton or whether it was with separate security firms around the state line. And one remembers they would each go to their birthdays at Texas Day Brazil, and they would try to set new records for how much meat they would eat for however long they would stand there. We'll have more reaction from his coworkers tonight on 13 News at 10, and for more coverage of this procession, we'll have it on our Facebook Live page. But for now, reporting live in Rockford for your 13 Weather Authority, I'm William Mingles. Back to you, Brittany.
William, thank you for that update there. Next to the very latest on the COVID-19 pandemic, you may have heard people getting antibody treatment. Doctors say it can be given through a transfusion or injection. Essentially, it boosts the immune system and gives at-risk people a better chance of staying out of the hospital. One local doctor says the treatment can help many people against COVID-19.
So some of the risk factors include things like COPD, obesity, cardiovascular disease, problems with the heart or the blood vessels, chronic kidney disease are all just a few examples.
Doctors say it is authorized for use in children.